Welcome to the Great Outdoors. My name is Mate.
I'm Tom, and today we're going to be talking about the Wildwood 28RLDS.
So Wildwood tries to make everything super easy for you and convenient.
Camper friendly.
Yes. Power awning, power stab jacks, power tongue jack, power slide out, all from a remote.
Remote control. Don't forget to turn on the lights too.
And turns on the lights.
I think on some coaches, yeah. So the Wildwood is our, basically this is called our stick and tin product. It's a wood framed aluminum sided coach with some insulation, R7 value. It's a great camper for those weekend getaways, maybe sometimes those extended trips. Nice little coach for you, for sure.
This is a classic floor plan that almost every manufacturer will make because it gives you the big, huge back window, the two chairs in the back with the beautiful views and everything. It has a super slide on it with both the couch
super slide
and the table and chairs so that you have just about everything in this one with a lot of room.
Yeah, in fact, the 28, the RLDS actually stands for Rear Living Dinette Slide. So you can always refer to that on our website when you're looking at pictures and videos and things of that nature.
Yep.
Yeah. So let's talk about this guy, mate. What do you think?
Let's do it.
So like we started off, so this coach can be controlled, almost entirely set up by a remote control. So Wildwood, the way they want to operate is that they want to design camping and make it user-friendly for people. You hear all the time, Tom, I just don't want to come in. I don't want to have to worry about jacks. I don't want to have to worry about setting the whole thing up. Wildwood takes that whole problem away from you. You pull in your spot, you look at whoever you're with and say, hey, this looks good, right? Yeah, everything looks good. This is where you want to be? Great. Hit a couple of buttons, stabilizers will go down, awning will kick out, your lights will turn on, slide out will go out, and you're set. Your job is to go in and get an adult beverage.
You know, I love
That's right. You're V8 for mate.
V8, yeah, I'll take a V8 or one of those green machine juices.
Sippy juices,
that'll work great.
5 hour energy.
I love the slide out remote because if there's another camper dude right beside you or a tree right beside you, you're coming inside, you're pushing the button, you're going outside, oh, I think I can go out a little bit further, you know, and you do that three times and it gets old.
Yep.
With the remote, it's nice. You can just watch it. Yep, looks like I'm going to be good. And you can be confident that you're not putting a giant hole in your side of your coach.
Yeah, so setup is a one-man band show. So let's walk around this and show some people.
Construction features on this is this. So since this is the aluminum sided, it's non-laminated. That means you don't have to worry about the glue gassing off and creating bubbles and starting to delaminate it.
Yep.
If you punch a hole in something like this, it's a little bit easier to replace a panel as opposed to replacing fiberglass.
Right.
This has 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking throughout the floor instead of OSB chipboard.
Yes.
And so that means you're not gonna have to worry about replacing the subfloor like you would if it got wet and it started to cup and bow with the wood chips and the glue disintegrating.
Yeah, that OSB chipboard will act like a sponge. So if you ever have a water problem, you won't have that problem with it absorbing in that OSB chipboard. You will have that problem, but the 5/8 you won't have the way it'll expand. You can just replace that section of the floor, repair it, and you're good to go.
Radial tires that are nitrogen filled, so that makes it handle better, brake better. Tread life will last longer. You can fill it up with normal air if that's what you have, but it starts out with nitrogen. That way you have some extra features for your tires.
Yep. Got your exhaust here for your heater. You're also going to have your access panel for your refrigerator if you need to gain access to this area right here. Condensation line is visible right here. That's completely normal.
This is a double entry coach. Pretty nice. One, because if there's a fire or something like that and you need to get out and hurry and one door gets blocked, you can get out quickly. You know, the other thing that I like about this one is it's not actually into your bedroom that this second door is. Some people think it's weird having a door in their bedroom. This one, it's into the hallway, and so, yeah, kind of solves that problem.
Yeah, it solves this too, especially if you're out and you're camping and you're playing and you're getting dirty and muddy and grungy. You can come in, dump your shoes right here, go right into the bathroom, use it as mudroom, change, do whatever before dragging all
that. Yeah, you're not trekking it all the way through the entire coach just for that.
Right. So, your stabilizers, as we talked about, are on a remote control. But believe it or not, they're all controllable too with a push button right here as well. Up and down features with this little touch of a button. So if you do want to go ahead and utilize those features manually, you definitely can do that.
One of the largest pass-through storages in the industry.
In the industry.
Is this Wildwood right here.
I bet you could fit in there, mate.
I bet I could. You want to try it out for us?
Yeah, I'll try it. Yeah. Why not, right? Yeah. You know what? I'm a very daring person. I have no problems. No. I have no problems getting in here and checking it out for the, you know, this is, I've never done this before, mate. This is something that, oh, goodness. Oh. Now, man, this is like a how to.
I told you there was.
Even Octavio is laughing. And is this cool or what, Octavio? So a human could actually fit in here, and there is tons of room up in here. Up underneath the pad, maybe I'll get out.
I'll come
this
in way. The easy way. So you can access all this from the inside of the coach as well.
Yeah. If
through all your sleeping bags and whatever else.
Coolers.
Yeah.
Extra clothes, camping chairs, fishing poles,
you
anything
don't have
you
to
can
go
think
outside.
Of.
Outside.
Yeah.
To get to all your stuff.
Maybe I should come out that way. That would probably be much easier for me.
And it's a little bit nicer because you have these struts here so that you can get out of here without it like, you know, falling apart on you.
Yeah. So let me come out that way and we'll continue on with this.
Hey, while you're down there,
yes.
Can you show us the little laundry chute right above
there? Sure. It's a little laundry chute. You're going to have this in the bedroom. So you put a little laundry basket right here. In fact, here, mate, when we go, okay, I'll just stay down here and I'll just collect the laundry.
Yeah, like right through here?
Like right through here. Right, punchy, right? So you could bring in all your clothes and dump them down here in the chute with this nice little laundry basket. And that way everything's organized. So when all you got to do is get home, just open up this little guy, pull your laundry out, take it to the washer, and you're good.
Let's finish the outside. And if you want to try that door, that's fine.
I don't think I'll make it, man. I don't think I'll make it. I'll hurt myself.
Right.
For sure.
There is a little light inside here too. I noticed that you can actually see what you're doing. And I see that there's a 110 outlet right over there as well. So some nice features. While he's working on his way getting back to us,
whew,
you'll notice the diamond plate.
That was an adventure, man. I have to tell you, I have never done that in one of our videos before.
Diamond plate is a little bit higher than the competition. Two 20-pound tanks underneath here with an auto changeover regulator. So it'll change from one tank over to the other automatically.
Yeah, so just want to, so Wildwood, so for those of you guys who don't know, we had Zach visiting a few weeks ago. He actually came out and did a video with me. The reason that they go with the 20 pounders is because they want you to have that easier exchange rate. So if you have the bigger bottles that are attached, like the 30 pounders, 40s, even the 50 pounders that you can have, you know, standalone outside of your camper, well, you have to actually take it to like a place like us, or someplace else that does propane. Well, if they're closed on the weekends or something going on, you need propane, you can just easily switch these out with a Home Depot or something like that, one for one exchange, and it makes it quick and easy.
Walmart, 7-Eleven.
Walmart, 7-Eleven, yeah.
Power tongue jack, this does have an automatic button so that you can, one, just make it go up and down, which is way nice if you're gonna buy a weight distribution hitch to put that on and off, as well as a little light so that you can actually see what you're doing if you're, you know,
hooking up at night.
Yeah, hooking up during the campsite time when it's not daylight. There is a manual override if you need it. This guy weighs 6,800 pounds dry, so, and then 7,800 pounds loaded, so easily towable by most of your half-ton towable trucks.
Yeah, but you'll definitely want to definitely look at your tow rating on your truck. Just to confirm that.
That's
for sure.
That's absolutely true. Over here, satellite and cable connections. You have, this is also where you're gonna dump your
black and your grays.
Black and gray tank. In case you've never messed with this before, you have a big, I think this is a 3-inch valve. This is for your black tank. So what you would do is you'd take this lid off here and then you'd open up your black tank. Then you'd shut your black tank and then you'd open up your gray tank and that'll clean out your hose basically that's fits onto here and then fits onto the ground and then you're set.
Yeah. You have your 30 amp service right in here.
I think they get the idea there, Tom.
Oh, okay, great. So
yeah.
You go to a campsite, you take your little 30 amp cord already attached to the camper here, plug it into your little receptacle and provide you power to run your AC, your
microwave, 110
outlets. 110 outlets, anything that you can think of that needs to be plugged in service, we'll run that. Yeah. City water connections also located right here. Hook that up with a water pressure reducing valve and you'll be good to go.
Yeah, the reason why you want to use a water pressure reducer valve is because some campsites have pressure as high as 90 to 110 PSI. Campers are designed for about 40 to 60 or 50 to 60 PSI. So if you put a water pressure reducer valve, you're less likely to get leaks and stuff like that, and instead of blowing a line or, you know, that kind of deal.
Yep.
Another thing to note is, so like Tom was saying, that runs microwave, AC, 110 power, charges your battery. The battery itself will run lights, your slide out, your stabilizer jacks, your awning, your power tongue jack, all those things will run off battery. As we're moving along.
Moving right along.
Spare tire on the back. This is a spot to put your sewer hose or fishing poles or whatever, right inside there. And let's head on inside and show them some features inside.
All right, let's do it. All right, mate. We're now inside the 28RLDS. How's the chair feeling?
Chair's nice. It's a rocker. Swivel rocker type deal. It is movable and it's light enough that it's easy for one guy to pick up and move wherever you need to. So you know what I would do is I would take this guy outside, put him underneath my awning, have my little campfire go. I'll have the nicest camp chair in the entire RV park.
Oh, is that right? Well, you know what? This couch is pretty comfy too.
Yeah.
Turns into a sleeper sofa area. Mm-hmm. But I think what's really cool about that Wildwood does is these nice little window treatments that are up here.
Yeah, they're a little bit more residential mm-hmm. feel to it instead of the weird lambrequin type stuff that a lot of RVs put on there.
Yeah, so Wildwood's whole concept was that, you know, they want you to have the feel of the house, and that kind of is what gives you with these little curtain rods that are on here and these little fold-up shades and stuff. Yeah, it's kind of nice.
Huge window. That is openable on the bottom half. This is where all your vistas are going to be, your beautiful scenery and stuff. And so it's nice to be able to turn these chairs around and enjoy the great outdoors from your air-conditioned unit.
Yeah. What's cool about Wildwood, too, is they're also going to give you a lot of cabinet space up in here. You've seen this on many, many coaches with this tempered glass that's on here along with these nice little pull handles. They do a great job as far as the quality of the cabinets plus the storage space that they do give you. As we're kind of coming through over in here, you'll have the dinette. But one of the things that we, like I said, we want to mention is that you got these pullable drawers, huge for pots and pans, real deep.
Well, and don't forget this one over here too, Tom. There's a nice one for blankets.
I did forget that one. Yep.
And things like that as well.
Pull out drawers that you get. Now, since we talked about the remote controls, here's the remote controls that come with this unit. So it's just a matter of, what guy doesn't like a remote control, right? I mean, just make things easier. So you'll just stand outside like Mate and I were talking about, hit your code and put in your put your little password in here and operate all the features according to just pushing something on here. So here's your little remote control. And then here's your little remote control also for your DVD CD player that's on board as well.
This is a solid surface countertop, so it makes it so that there's not T-molding along here that can get junk, like food and stuff like that, stuck in the piece of, you know, T-molding that would go across here. High-rise sink faucet, so you can put your bigger pots and pans in here as opposed to the smaller one that just sits like this a lot of times.
Yeah, you have these double cabinets up here, great for cups, plasticware. You have a microwave that's on board. You're also going to have a three-burner stove with a little knife holder, which I will demonstrate. You put that little guy right in there, and then you can travel down the road and leave your knives right on in there. Did you get that, Octavio? Cool. Nice little oven as well, along with a six cubic foot refrigerator, and then you have a freezer also on board. Now, this is an LP electric option on here. This is a Dometic refrigerator, stainless steel option on here. So you can run either both. Keep your food cold as you're pulling down the road with your propane, and then once you get to your campsite, plug yourself in and run that way.
Another cool feature on this guy is it has a built-in monitor panel. So if you want to know how much battery you have left, how much fresh water, gray water, black water, you can tell that by just pushing a button here and it will light up and tell you how full or empty your tanks are.
You're also going to have a 12,500 BTU AC
13,000
My mistake. 13,000 BTU air conditioner on board. It's also going to be ducted. Now, a lot of our competition, they won't even have a ducted option on here. They'll just put the AC right here, and then it's supposed to cool off this area. Well, in the front bedroom can get kind of warm. So with it being ducted, you'll be sure to stay cool throughout your trip.
But if you're not going to use the bedroom during the daytime and you're wanting to cool off just this unit, it does have the quick cool feature that you can open this up, and it'll dump all the cold air into this area alone. That way it'll cool down the living room instead of the living room and bedroom when you really don't need the bedroom cooled at that time.
Right. Your heat's also going to come. It's going to be coming from the floor. It's two separate systems, so your AC will come from the ceiling. Your heat system will come from the floor.
And I don't know if we mentioned it, but the dinette also turns into a bed.
It does.
The way this works is if you have some kiddos with you and you're at the lake or something like that, this does have vinyl on the bottom side of it to protect you from getting your fabric all grungy and wet. Or it's spaghetti-o-night.
Yeah, let's convert this.
You want to see how that works?
All right. You got there?
There we all go. Right.
All right.
There you go.
And that's comfy cozy too. Oh man, you totally
took your spot.
You totally took my move.
So, you would probably have to sleep on it a little sideways, or maybe a teenager could be on here.
Well,
I would be fine actually if that was just me.
And most people are going to sleep in that half fetal position anyway. So people, you have to realize that too, that when you're actually sleeping, that's not how most folks sleep. Everybody kind of, in a way, will sleep curled up.
Especially if you have like your stuffed animal with you, or a blankie. That's definitely.
I have my little 11 pound Gabe.
Yep.
He's a great cuddler.
Toy poodle, schnauzer, or something.
Yep, that's exactly how it is. Yep.
All right.
Hey, you should see. I put a motorcycle helmet on the other day.
Oh,
he
nice.
Looked awesome.
We need to see some Facebook pictures of that.
No Facebook. I don't do Facebook.
Okay.
Here's your DVD system right here. So you can also, now this doesn't come with a TV, but if you want to utilize this feature, everything right here to utilize that is going to be right here, along with the TV booster 110 and all of your gaming.
Well, this is for your DVD. So since this has a built-in DVD player, a lot of guys competition are just doing a CD player up here. This one
is for your Xbox.
Well, no, for your DVD, and this is video and audio from the DVD player.
Right. Yeah. More cabinet space here in the garage here.
Garage
hallway. God, you can tell it's a Monday today, can't you? Can't even speak right today.
You'll notice here in the bathroom that this has a nice glass roller style enclosure, neo-angled, plenty of headroom with the skylight so that you have some natural light going through here.
And you know, this is a great feature to...
Hey, Tom.
Hey, how's it going, bud?
Hey, I feel like a little claustrophobic in here, man. No, actually, there is plenty of room to kind of hang out.
Plenty of room, but if you ever wanted to play a trick on your spouse or a friend, that would be a great way to do it, right?
There is a medicine cabinet in here as well, sink, and of course a GFI outlet, toothbrush holder, more storage underneath here, plenty of leg room for the throne, the commode.
Yeah, the throne, the commode. And the cool feature about this one, I think this is what makes this particular unit, is that you have the wardrobe that's actually on a slide out on this particular coach. Plenty of space in here for hanging clothes and pants. It's not, you know, it's not one of those small ones. You actually have an actual, you know, space width to hang up your shirts and stuff like that. So it's not all hanging sideways. Here's the laundry chute that Mate and I were talking about earlier. You got some more wardrobe space right here, but I think what's cool about this is it gives you the walk around queen size bed.
It makes it way easier to make the bed at night or in the morning or whatever. And then you saw from the outside how much storage it is. Probably, again, one of the biggest storage areas out there.
Yeah, nice comfortable bed. And of course, my favorite, throw pillows.
Yep.
It goes with your shirt.
Does go with our shirt. It's my shirt. All right.
Well, thanks. Thanks, guys, for hanging out with us today on the Wildwood 28RLDS. This is Mate, I'm Tom. Come on down and see us, or?
Our phone number is 970-313-4337, or visit us on the web at
www.thegreyoutdoorsrv.com. Take care.
Thanks.